we are going to integrate square root of 1 minus 4x squared. As you can see, we have the number 1 in front, and that's the first situation because we have the a squared, a is the number, okay? So we're expecting to use the substitutions right here. But then we don't want to have the 4 in front of the x squared. This can only work if you have minus x squared, right? So this is the small thing that we can do. You have two choices. One, you can do some use substitutions. You can put parentheses and say this is 2x and then square. You don't need to worry about that. What we can do is I can factor out the 4, okay? So I'm going to look at this, and then I'm going to say this is the same as the integral square root. I'm going to bring down a 4, okay, like this. Originally, I have 1. If I factor out a 4, I will have 1/4 left. So inside will be 1 over 4. Originally, we have minus 4x squared. The 4 is out now, so we have minus x squared, okay, dx. And then what good does this do? Of course, this is just square root of 4, which is the number 2. The 2 can go all the way in the front, so we have the 2. And the integral square root, this is 1/4, and 1/4 will be the a squared, okay? So let me write this down. This is 1/4 minus x squared dx. But then we have to look at the 1/4 as 1/2 squared, and a will be the 1/2. And then we'll begin by saying that x equals to 1/2 times sine theta, and we'll take this integral into the theta world. So we begin by saying x equals to 1/2 sine theta, and then perhaps we can, of course, differentiate both sides. We get 1/2, the relative sine is going to be cosine theta d theta, okay? Let me erase this, and now let's continue. This will be, the 2 is still the 2 right here, the integral is still the integral sine, of course. Square root, we have 1/4 minus x squared. We have to square both sides right here. 1/2 squared, we get 1 over 4. And then we have sine squared theta. And then for the dx part, we have 1/2 times cosine theta. So I also have to multiply by 1/2 cosine theta. And then, of course, let's attach the d theta. OK? All right, so what we have? The 1/2 and the 2 were canceled. That's nice. And let me just write it down right here. Inside of the square root, they both have the 1/4, so I can factor out the 1/4. And this is the integral of square root. We have the 1/4, and the inside is just 1 minus sine square theta, and then we have a cosine theta on the outside, d theta, and then let's put parentheses right here. Okay, let me put it right here. Square root of 1 over 4 is the number 1/2. I can take that outside. So this is 1/2 integral, and then we have to work out the square root of 1 minus sine square. But then 1 minus sine square is what? And as you can see, we can expect to use this identity right here. 1 minus sine square theta is the same as cosine square theta. Let me put this down. But then this is still underneath the square root. So then we have, altogether, we have cosine theta right here. But then we have another one right here, cosine theta d theta. And of course, we can multiply this out together. Altogether, we have cosine square theta d theta. OK? And now the question becomes, how can we integrate this? We have to use the power reduction formula that we have seen in 7.2. So let's get back to here, 1/2. So for cosine square theta, this is the same as integrating 1/2 times 1 plus cosine of 2 theta by one of the trig identity, the power reduction formula. And then we are still talking about d theta. Of course, the 1/2 can go all the way in the front, so we have altogether 1/4, and then still the integral, and then the inside is 1 plus cosine parentheses 2 theta d theta. And we are finally ready to integrate. And let me just put down the answer right here. This is going to be 1 over 4. The integral of 1 in the theta world is theta. And to integrate cosine, we get positive sine. So let me put down plus sine, and the input will stay the same, so 2 theta. But then the derivative inside is 2. So we divide it by 2. Let's multiply by 1/2 like this. So that's the integrating part, and we are done with the integration. All this right here, all come down to this part. Then that's all the fun is, integrate from here to here. And then the other stuff is just trig identities. And now we have to take this expression back to the X world. How can we do that? Well, the one force is a number, so don't worry too much about that yet. But theta is what? Let's look at this equation right here. We say x is equal to 1/2 sine theta. We can multiply both sides by 2. So we have, let me write down right here. Okay, let me just put this down right here. Multiply both sides by 2, we have what? 2x is equal to sine theta. And then I want to know what theta is. What I can do is, of course, I can do the inverse theta on both sides, inverse sine on both sides. So we can look at this as inverse 2x will be theta. And then we are done for this part. We are going to use this for that. So perhaps let me put that down right here. And of course, I'm going to distribute. The first part I'm going to get is 1 over 4 theta, which is that inverse sine of 2x. Okay. And then for this part, we are going to get 1 over 8. But then you see sine of 2 theta, the angle right here is a double angle. The angle right here is just a theta, so we cannot make a connection right away. But then we can use a double angle formula. Sine of 2 theta is the same as 2 sine theta cosine theta. Okay? And then this 2 and that 2, I mean this 2 and that 1/2 will cancel out. So when you distribute, you just have a 1 over 4. So let me put that down. Plus 1 over 4. And now my goal is figure out what sine theta is, cosine theta is. We already know what sine theta is. Sine theta is the same as 2x, so I can put that down right away. So this is the same as 2x. And now I have to figure out what cosine theta is. And I can look at this equation again. And then the usual way that we can do this is, I can look at this and then draw a right triangle, put the right angle here, and put the angle theta here. And then remember, sine is the same as, let's look at this as a fraction, 2x over 1, okay? In the right triangle, sine means we have the opposite, which is 2x, let me label that, over 1, and the 1 will be the hypotenuse. So we have the 1 right here. And to figure out the adjacent, it will be this square minus that square, so 1 square is just 1, minus 2x squared, which is 4x squared. Don't forget to square the 2 as well, but then you include the square root, okay? So you can look at this picture and then figure out what cosine theta is. But looking at this picture, cosine theta, theta is right here. Cosine is the same as adjacent, which is square root of 1 minus 4x squared over hypotenuse, which is 1. So let me just put down, multiplying by that, 1 minus 4x squared. And guess what? We are done. But then, of course, this is a 4, this is a 2, we can reduce them. So perhaps I'll just write down the final answer. This is 1 over 4 inverse sine function of 2x, and then this is going to be reduced to 1/2 x, and then square root of 1 minus 4x squared. And we put down a plus c for the final answer. Okay, that's it.